but he was not ready. Something happened, but he was not what? He was not ready. So somebody don't ask me, Pastor, what of the woman of issue of blood? Everybody was touching Jesus, but her own touch was special. Lift up your right hand. Say, Father, this year 2020, my touch will be a special touch. In the name of Jesus. And so when that woman touched Christ, touched Jesus, Jesus said, something have left out of me. So everybody can pray. It's not everybody prayer can touch Christ. Even when Jesus was asking, who touched me? Peter said, shut up. You man of war. You man of war. How much people that is here? And you asking who touched you? This small boy, what is your problem every time, every time, every time? Somebody touches you. If people here touching you and they say, Jesus said no. Something have left me. Because it is a special touch. It is a year of a special touch. It is a year that when you appear before God, it is neither you bless me, I will not let you go. God, listen, until you come to the point, if I perish, I perish. Prayer will not be answered. Why did Hannah got pregnant? She got pregnant because she get radical. Bible says she cried. That even the prophet came out and looked at her, he said, woman, are you drunk? He said, I was not drunk, but I'm just dealing with my situation the way it is in my heart. The woman came to that altar with a great expectation. Jesus Christ said, I will give unto him that I have what? Expectation of what? The fountain of what? Of water. And when you have the expectation of the fountain of water, what will he do? He said, of life freely. He said, he will not give you free. He doesn't need to pay for it. He don't pay for miracle. Anybody that tell you to pay for miracle is a thief. Any person that tell you to pay for miracle is a thief. He don't pay for miracle. What did he say? He says, somebody say freely. What does the word name freely mean? Something very free. Something you don't, nothing is attached to you. The only thing is, did you know that your desire is 20 million in deposit to get you a miracle? That's why they say that expectation is the mother of manifestation.
Yes.
When you don't have expectation in anything you are doing, I said something today in church, and let me try and see how people are receiving. Please forgive me, I eat a lot of corn when I was hungry. I eat like almost 5 corn. I said something here. Remember that action without thought is empty. And thought without action is blind. So this year, your action must not be empty. Your thought must not be empty. Your thought must have an expectation.
Yes.
And so it is important that you are taught to have what? Expectation. So, as God has declared this year, our year of all grace, what grace carries and what carries grace will work for every man, for every woman, in every area of your life. But the problem is this, what do you have as a desire? So, let's start right now and see something. The race. Therefore, as we run this race day by day, we can become entangled with the cares of this world. Today is the 5th. Do you know there are some people here that is still worried? Anyone here that is worried? Don't lie. Lift up your hand. If there is anyone who could the cares of this world. Any other person? Any other person? I love you. Sincere to yourself. God bless you, my boy. Thank my boy. Amen. You are worried. Anxiety. Are you hearing me? You are anxious for one thing or the other. The more you run this race, be careful because you can be entangled with the fears of this world. And when you become afraid of this world, you can't hold the word of God the way you're supposed to hold it. Because there will be a lot of doubt. out in you. Now, as we go on, let us start looking at this. It's very important we know this. But we are made to know that the most important thing in our life is not even where we walk. Because that's one thing people know now. Where you go every morning to work, you think that is more important. The most important thing is not your family. Some people will put me wrong. Because there are some people that have placed value on distance more than they place on Christ. Follow me. I didn't say you should neglect your family, right? Follow me. I said the most important thing is not. The most important thing as far as our salvation is concerned is keeping our hearts full of the light of the Word of God. How can you be a good husband if you don't have the Word of God? So you see that the most important thing is not the family. If you don't have the light of the Word of God, how can you treat the family good? You keep on cursing the children and the children, but all of them will be running wherever they want to. But when you are alive, your heart is full of what? The light of the Word of God. That is the most important. Why? Because whatever you face or whatever that comes on your way, you use what you have to fight. Because the Word of God is our weapon. The Word of God is our armor. So when you have the Word of God in this season, you have all it takes to succeed in this season. Why do I say that? I say that it will take the Word of God in you to establish your kingdom dominion. If there is no Word of God in you, you have no kingdom dominion. Therefore, your life will become like a handkerchief. When Jesus was at the mountain, the devil came to him and the devil began to tempt him, telling him, if you say you are the Son of God, you do this. Jesus did not say, hold on, let me go to my father and come back. Jesus did not say, okay, let me go to my family and come back. What did Jesus do? Jesus used the bullet in him to respond back.
Amen.
So every child of God, the Word of God you have in you is the bullet in you. That whenever the devil shoots at you, you do what? You shoot back at him. Listen, this year, do not allow the devil to have the final say. Follow me again. Don't allow the devil. If the devil say one, say ten. Did you know? Because when you read the book of Luke chapter 4, because Jesus Christ had the final say, that's what the Bible says, and the devil left him for a season. Because when he said one, Jesus said two. He said three, Jesus said four. He said, man, this one is not the person you can deceive. Okay, let me just leave him for the season. This month, this year, the devil will leave you for the season.
Amen.
I said, the devil will leave you for the season.
Amen.
So we have to know this. It is very, very important. But if you know this, things will not change. For you to have or establish your dominion, kingdom dominion. Luke chapter 10. This is very important that we have to know this. Very, very, very important. Luke chapter 10, we'll read from verse 38 to 42. I want everybody, please, to take your time and let's look at this. Now it came to pass, as they went, that he entered into a certain village, and a certain woman named Martha received him into his own house. She had a sister called Mary. So Mary is not the owner of the house. It is Martha is the owner of the house. So Mary is the small sister to Martha. Now, and she had a sister called Mary, which also sat at the feet. Jesus' feet and do what? Had his word. This year, it doesn't matter the voice you hear. You have to live by the voice of the Word of God. I want you to look at this, because in this scripture we're going to look at who was doing right and who was doing wrong. A whole Jesus, big man, Jesus is Lord, the Son of God, get into your house. So we're gonna look at when Jesus came into our house, what happened?
Next verse.
And Jesus answers, go to verse 4. But Martha was the one troubled about much serving, and came to him and said, Lord, thou dost not care that my sister had left me to serve alone. Be her therefore that she was telling Jesus, my sister left me in the kitchen. We have a great visitor like you. My sister left me in the kitchen just to do only the cooking. And my sister is here by your feet. And you leave him. Tell him to come back so that he will come and help me in the kitchen. Which every one of us can do. Two of us. Two of us. Yeah, because Jesus entered your house. Jesus entered your house. You want big prime minister? Can I just say that prime minister came to your house and you have to show you one sister? And already you prepare all the calamus and lose everything you want. All the salad and everything. And every one of them was half done, half done, half done. And the only sister you have will just leave you to go and sit by the prime minister and be talking story. What will you do? You will be angry. Why will she do that? The prime minister is supposed to eat. Why will she leave me here to go and say to the prime minister? Mary went and told Jesus, it's better you call my sister, let her come and help me because I can't serve alone. Give me verse 41. And Jesus answered and said unto her, let's read, 1, 2, 3, go. Martha, Martha, who is Jesus calling? Who is Jesus calling this evening? We're not going to go on Martha, Martha. I want you to put your name. Kenneth. Kenneth. Oh, yeah, put your name. Kenneth. 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 Put your name. Kenneth. Kenneth. For Jesus to call your name two times, something is wrong. Pay attention. Attention. He's calling you back to attention. Nigel! Nigel! God is calling you back to attention. Careful and troubled about many things. So put it, the woman that was looking to serve him is troubled about many things. So that was not important. I have come to the point of looking at that scripture that said that man shall not live by bread.